Hilda.
Yes,
have you seen
Corey?
Amanda? I just was upstairs and she's not in her room.
I haven't seen Miss Corey since yesterday morning.
Well, you mean except for last night?
No, ma'am. Her bed wasn't slept in.
I see. Thank you, Hilda.
Hey, darling! I didn't know you were back.
Oh, I tried calling, but Michelle said you were on your way here from the airport.
Yeah, I came straight here, but I took a walk down to the creek. See that big tree?
Oh.
It refuses to let go of its leaves. I mean, it's standing there defiant in scarlet and gold.
How nice.
Anything wrong, sweetheart?
No, nothing's wrong at all. Tell me about the tree.
Oh, well, it's just such a great symbol of fall. Thanksgiving.
Oh, I never heard so much baloney in my life.
Well, Julia Childs...
Talk about too many cooks. Julia Childs can make her own giblet gravy.
And there is the voice of Thanksgiving, Ava defending her gravy.
Bet your books.
Hey, go on, man. What is this?
I love the holidays.
Family, friends, kids all gathered up together.
I don't ever want to let you go.
Then don't.
How about we stay here forever?
We already discussed that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What did we decide? I forgot.
We decided that we have to be realistic.
Oh, that's my least favorite word.
Mm. Oh, no.
What?
I can't believe it's this late. I've really got to go.
Why? Mm. Why?
Sam, look at the time.
I've got better things to look at.
Sam, please. I've really got to go.
What did Cass say to you? I mean, you're acting so different.
Well, it wasn't what he said.
Oh, would you like to explain that?
I think this marriage of convenience might turn out to be more than convenient.
Nicole, are you saying...
I think he cares for me. I really do.
Oh, honey.
I know.
What are you doing?
What is this, the maid?
No, wait a minute. What do you think you're doing in here?
I'm so sorry.
No, what are you doing in here?
No, I was making up the room, and I saw some of your things, and they were so beautiful. I know I shouldn't have been touching them.
Oh, no, you don't.
But I have other rooms to make up. I'll come back later.
No, I don't think so. Donna, you get on the phone, and you call the manager. You're not going anywhere.
You sit down right there. Make yourself comfortable. You might be here for a while.
Nicole, what about your jewelry?
What's with the manager?
I can't even get the the manager's office, please. Hello, we're in suite 2337. My sister and I came in here and we found some woman who says she's a maid just going through her things. All right, yes, thank you.
Well, none of my jewelry seems to be missing.
Oh, good. The manager said that he was sending his security up right away.
Wait a minute.
What?
Daddy. He could be behind this.
Well, how?
No, maybe he hired this woman to spy on me.
Well, I certainly wouldn't put that past him.
No. He would hire a real professional. And this woman isn't that.
I'm telling you, I'm just the maid.
Wait a minute. Barbara Van Arkdale.
Yes. Now that would make sense. Nicole, your designs. What about your designs?
Oh, where are they? Check. Are they all still here?
It looks like
it. No! Stop her! No! Donna!
Oh, after the wedding. I've got to get back in shape.
Well, come on. Now, she couldn't have gotten out of the tower. Let me go call security again. Yes, this is Donna Hudson again, 2337. That woman who was dressed up as a maid, she just ran out of here. And she was really acting very strange. All right. Yes, we will. Thank you.
There is something very weird here.
I'm going to lock this door until security comes up here.
Okay. What do we know?
A woman dressed as a maid and a wig and everything was going through your things.
But she didn't take anything. That's what gives me the creeps.
Did you notice the expression on her face?
When?
Well, when you entered the room. I mean, she gave you this look like, I don't know, like she was furious with you.
Well, that doesn't make sense.
No, it really doesn't, does it?
No, it's probably because I walked in on her.
Right. What were we talking about when we walked in here? Oh, right. And you think that maybe he's starting to have feelings for you?
Maybe.
Well, what happened?
Well, a woman knows these things.
And a woman can be very mistaken.
What are you doing here?
I'm a volunteer.
Oh, that's nice of you.
I'm on the St. Elmo's Homeless Committee.
Oh, that's very nice of you, Mary. What happened to St. Anne's?
I don't go there anymore.
How come?
Well, you know, I was sort of running into you every Sunday, and I thought it was a little bit awkward, so...
Oh, yeah, right, yeah.
So I go here now.
Well, this is a nice parish.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the people are lovely.
Yeah, and who knows, maybe they'll even let you sing in their choir.
I guess you want the kitchen.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
It's over there.
Go. Got to know where these little birds go.
Mr. McKinnon!
Oh, sister! Hi.
Good man, you're right on time.
Thank you.
We've got a dozen hands waiting for these birds.
Oh, now, just be careful with those things, you know. They're heavy.
Mom, listen, I'll call.
What?
Oh, the telephone. I'll try and get a hold of Amanda.
But I've already tried calling. I called Sam's loft. I called the office.
Well, perhaps Julianne has heard something.
That's a good idea. Why don't you try? Thank you.
Yeah.
Please let me help you. Jamie's been raving about your sausage stuffing.
Yeah, she's real serious about this cooking stuff.
Okay, but I've been making this sausage stuffing for centuries. If I hear one put some garlic in it, or what about basil, you turn in your apron.
Okay.
Logs, Matthew. Half a dozen or so should do.
Aye, aye, sir.
Hey, Matthew, you know, we might as well bring in enough logs for tomorrow, too, you know.
Okay.
I'll help you load you up. Shouldn't take more than 3 or 4 loads.
Thanks a lot, Adam.
Oh, it's so good to be home.
Oh, I love Thanksgiving.
I love any holiday if it's with you.
You know, Zurich wasn't the same. It was too cold. Maybe that was just me. Maybe I just wanted to be here back with you.
That's what I love to hear. I love you.
I love you, too. Very, very much.
You know, I've called Julianne, and she hasn't seen Amanda either.
Oh, she'll show up, Jamie.
Well, she'd better do it sooner. She's going to be in deep trouble.
Yeah, well, I had a great day today, thanks.
Oh, you really have to go?
Yeah, my grandma's expecting me.
Well, have fun.
Yeah, she's really looking forward to it.
And you're not.
Yeah, sure I am.
Well, I bet Claire is very happy to be back in her own house, huh?
And to be away from Donna. I hate holidays. Oh, that's the way. Vicky, why don't you just feel sorry for yourself? It's really
attractive. You don't have to worry about that with me.
Thanks. Oh, tell your grandma I am sorry that I can't witness the battle of the sausage stuffing, okay?
Lisa plays grandma like a violin.
Yeah. Oh, well, I'll see you at the wedding, okay?
I wouldn't miss it.
Oh. Bye.
Now, come on, we'll jack this fire up.
Any luck?
No luck.
Do you know what I just love about Thanksgiving?
What?
It's a whole holiday about eating.
Ah, no gifts and no guilt.
You got it.
Why do I get the feeling that you know more than you're telling me?
Why do I get the same feeling about you?
I feel so close to you.
I can't believe we're still here in this hotel room.
I can't.
I'll never forget this day, Sam.
You're really something. Do you know that?
Something?
Sensational. Incredible.
Let's not get too carried away, right?
I am carried away. You are all those things and more.
No, I'm not.
Hey. I liked you from the first moment you walked into my office.
That is not true.
It is too.
I remember that day.
I thought to myself, now here is a woman with spirit, ambition, a sense of humor.
That's all, huh?
I find you so intriguing, elusive almost.
Elusive?
Well, yeah. I mean, no matter how straightforward you are with me, there's still so much that I don't know about you.
You like that?
It makes me want to know more.
Well,
you really have to go, don't you?
That's what I've been trying to tell you for the past 2 hours.
When am I going to see you next?
About later this afternoon.
Great. Do you want me to come over to your place?
No, that wouldn't be good. How about down by the lake? There's some woods down Colton Road.
Okay. Is that where your family lives?
No. I mean, why would it be? That's a really ritzy area. Didn't you know that?
No, not really.
Well, it is. That doesn't matter. Just be there, okay?
So I'm gonna see you later this afternoon, right?
Yeah.
Well, I guess I can wait that long.
So much to be thankful for.
Oh, yeah? Where'd you get an idea like that?
Oh, I don't know. Think about it.
Well, let me see. No, it couldn't be.
Could it be Thanksgiving?
Son of a gun. I knew there was a reason Grandma was cooking a turkey. I wonder if she thinks John is going to show up.
I hope she's not too disappointed.
Well, I think it's just fine, the three of us. I'll have a good time.
Me too. Oh, Dad.
Why?
Well, I was going to wait until dinner, but...
Why? Come
on. I can't. Here.
What is this?
It was waiting for me at the hotel when I got there.
Okay, this is a letter.
Yeah, read it.
Oh, Vicky.
Are you surprised?
Well, I had no idea you were serious
about
this.
Well, I'm very serious.
Honey, does anybody else know about this?
No, I wanted to try it out myself first.
Well, try it out.
Well, let me introduce myself.
Okay. Go ahead.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dad, the former Miss Victoria Love is now officially and legally, she's been in her heart for a long time, Miss Victoria Hudson.
That was beautiful.
Thank you, Bridget.
Mr. Reginald, I told you, I don't know when Miss Donna's going to be back.
What are you doing here? I'm sure Donna doesn't want to see you, so why don't you just take off?
Are you spending a lot of time here now?
No, I just came by here to get rid of you.
It's Thanksgiving, John. Time for families to be together.
Give me a break.
Actually, I was going to give Donna a break. Take her out, cheer her up.
Oh, Miss Donna.
Reginald.
And here she is.
He's only been here a little while.
Hello, Donna. Nicole.
John, what are you doing here?
No, Miss Donna, you've got to rest now, you know. I'll put on the kettle. Yes, now you're looking very pale. Are you sure you're all right, dear?
Actually, no, I'm not.
Oh. What's wrong, darling?
She just did too much today. From now on, she's going to have to really take it easy. Well, come on. Don't just stand there. Why don't you give me a hand? Mm-hmm. And someone find Jamie Frame's number. She may need a doctor.
It's okay.
Hey, anybody want to stop eating and get some exercise?
I will later, but right now, I haven't seen your mother in so long.
Oh, darling, it's all right.
Cool it, will you? Have you ever seen how far this guy throws a pass?
What about you, Adam?
Who, me? Oh, no, I have to take care of my arm.
Your arm? What's
wrong?
What's wrong with your arm?
This is the arm I used to hold the magnifying glass with. This is my cue arm. I can't...
Oh,
anything happens, I don't solve any cases.
Elementary, Matthew. Okay.
I got it.
Mackenzie Corey. Don't you move a muscle. I'll be right there.
Where?
I thought you had to stay with Mom.
Be right back.
Where are you going? What's going on?
Why don't you ask the super sleuth over here? I have two pumpkin pies to make. How would you like to try that passing arm out on a rolling pin?
It's girl stuff. It's woman's work.
Sexist.
And in this liberated household, too. Come on, Joe Montana. Into the kitchen.
I will contribute an arm.
Well, I'd be happy to help, but, you know...
Oh, yeah.
Oh, sure. Sure.
Excuse me.
Corey residence.
Doc, look, this is John Hudson. We've got a little problem over here at the Love Estate.
What's wrong?
Yeah, it's Donna. She says she's dizzy.
I'll be right over. House called the Hudsons. Keep the fire burning for me. I'll be right back.
Gee, was it something I said?
You know, Vicky didn't really want to leave.
Ooh, where did that come from?
She likes you, Adam.
Well, I like her, too. She's got, spirit.
And she's gorgeous.
I don't know. A year ago, I wouldn't have said so. I would have said, no way, not my type.
Now?
Well, if it isn't Vicky, maybe time for me to move on.
Good. You've been lonely.
And who knows? Maybe I'll get lucky like my cousin Jamie.
Yeah, it's, shaky.
Yeah. Well, they're gonna set up for the first sitting. Oh. I think I'll sit.
Oh. What's wrong?
Oh, nothing. Just do-gooders should wear more comfortable shoes.
Let me see. Come here. Oh, yeah, you're still wearing heels that are too high. I'm doing it again. I promised myself. I wouldn't do it.
What? Look at my feet?
There's got to be a psychiatric term for it, you know?
Psychiatric term for what?
For me living in the past. There's got to be some way you can stop that.
Why do you figure you do it?
Well, you're the shrink. You tell me.
Well, perhaps it's just that the present is, empty.
You get $75 an hour? For garbage like that?
Hey, I'm not a shrink. But if I were, I would probably, you know, go on to say that possibly you just feel that there's something unresolved in your past.
Well, I guess we both know what that could be. Did you know that I was going to be over here this afternoon?
No, I had absolutely no idea.
Well, what do you think that means? Is fate for us or... or against us?
Let's go.
What are you doing, Hudson? Take your hands off me.
It's you who needs company. It's a holiday and you're all alone.
Please.
Get out.
Me the dime store psychology.
Out!
Call me if you need me, Donna.
Where is she?
She's on the couch.
Okay, what do we have here?
Jamie, no, really, I'm fine. You didn't need to come. I'm sorry.
Just relax now.
She got weak all of a sudden.
And very pale.
Do you have any cramps, Donna?
No, I don't.
Any bleeding?
None.
Okay, then. Well,
I don't think we should worry about this too much. We probably just need to get some rest.
Yes, you see, that's what I've been telling her. You know, she's a very fragile lady. I mean, I keep telling her, as a matter of fact, I begged her. I said, you should just let the world go by. That's what I said. I mean, a woman like her, I mean, she shouldn't worry about things like that when she's expecting.
Expecting?
Pies smell real good. It's going to be a good dinner.
Not if you don't cheer up, it won't.
All right.
Oh, that's why you look like you just lost your best friend.
I'm fine, really.
No, you're not. So why don't you let it out so we can all relax and have a good time?
Have I ever apologized to you?
You're changing the subject.
No, I'm not. I must have driven you crazy when I was a kid.
To say nothing of lately.
I've been thinking about it a lot. I am sorry. Sorry for all the times I made you worry. All the times I made you feel as though you were always getting in my way.
Kids do that.
Doesn't make it right.
Amanda must really be giving you a hard time.
It's Thanksgiving. I have no idea where she is. Amanda? Amanda?
Lots of luck, pal.
Hi, Mom.
Where have you been?
I was out on a date.
Hilda said you didn't come home last night.
I didn't.
Would you care to explain that?
I'd love to explain it. But later.
Now.
Now is not a good time.
It is for me.
The house is full of people.
Well, you should have thought of that before you came sneaking back in here wearing last night's dress.
I did think of it.
And you didn't care?
I saw Dad pulling away.
Oh, I see. You thought you could get away with it.
Yes.
What about me?
What about you?
You didn't think I'd be just a little thrown by this? Or are your father's feelings the only feelings you care about?
I care about your feelings, too.
Well, it's hard to believe, behaving the way you're behaving.
Sorry.
Amanda, this is a holiday. You didn't even have the courtesy to call us and tell us where you were.
I didn't think.
Well, why don't you start thinking? Why don't you have the guts to tell us what's going on?
I spent the night with Sam.
I see.
I don't think you do.
Amanda, I'm not a fool. Your father and I were on business trips and you took advantage.
No.
How do you see it?
It was what I wanted. I would have done it anyway.
Are you in love?
I don't know yet.
Does Sam love you?
I hope he will.
He doesn't now?
I don't know.
Well, obviously he hasn't told you or you would know.
What are you getting at?
I'm trying to figure out what kind of an affair this is, Amanda. Is it serious, semi-serious, casual?
That isn't fair.
I think I have a right to know.
You don't have a right to make fun of it.
I don't know what to make of this.
Sam and I care about each other very deeply.
I hope that's true. Because you have been ignoring everything else in your life to be with Sam.
Could you get off my back?
With pleasure.
Mom, wait. I'm sorry. I just don't know how to talk to you about this.
Well, you've been doing just fine up until now.
I'm only taking the advice that you gave me.
I have never advised you to sleep around.
No, but you told me to go with my feelings, and that if I met someone that I thought was special, I would know when the time was right.
I told you that.
I haven't done anything that you didn't do at my age.
That doesn't make it right, Amanda. And we're not talking about me, we're talking about you. And why did you have to... With Mitch Blake's brother?
Would you feel better if it was with someone else?
No, I wouldn't. Why didn't you talk to me about it? Why didn't you just consult me or something?
It just didn't work out that way. I'm sorry.
Well, I hope it worked out for you to use contraception.
Yes.
Are you all right? Are you happy, at least?
Sam's a wonderful man, Mom. I knew that the day I met him. I am so happy. Can you at least be happy for me, please?
I think you better go up and change your clothes.
Well, thanks for trying to understand.
This conversation isn't over yet.
What are you looking at me like that for?
I never would have been able to tell my mother I was having an affair.
Isn't this better?
For you, I think it's better. I don't know about for me. I still think of you as one of my babies. And now you've taken on a very adult responsibility.
You make it sound so serious.
It is very serious. You take care of yourself, okay? Please.
Thanks again, Jamie. Enjoy your holiday.
How long have you known?
Not long.
Well, what did Mike say when you told him?
He didn't.
He doesn't know?
No. And he won't until I start to show.
Oh, come on. That is the dumbest thing I've ever... You get on the phone and call him right
no.
now.
No. I've made up my mind.
Then unmake it.
No. No, this is the way it's going to be, John.
If you won't call him, I will.
Don't. You do it.
You don't want your husband back, is that it?
Of course I do. More than anything in this world.
Then what are you saying?
I want him to come back when he wants to. When he feels like he can trust me again.
I can't believe you're talking like this.
Well, you might as well believe it. Oh, and I've had plenty of practice with this argument.
Who knows you're pregnant?
Nicole, Bridget, Felicia, and Jamie, of course.
But not Mike.
No. And I don't want him to come back because he thinks I'm blackmailing him. I don't want that.
Donna, he is the father of your child.
No pity. I don't want him feeling that way, and I don't want him to feel that he's responsible.
Well, he is responsible.
John, I want him to come back to me because he loves me.
What you're doing isn't right.
Oh, of course, and you understand that. Because everything you've always done has always been right.
Ever think of switching parishes, Mr. McKinnon?
Well, Father, you know.
I could try to arrange for a trade.
Two minor leaguers and a player to be named later?
Say, you played first base for St. Anne's in the Church League, didn't you?
Good field. No hit.
You're right.
Why, I oughta.
You guys
oh,
eat.
There you go.
Enjoy. And there's more if you
excuse
need.
Me?
Okay.
Happy Thanksgiving.
You can start. It's all.
No hit. You think you're pretty funny, don't you?
Really nice of you to stay and help out.
Well, I don't have anything better to do.
What about tonight?
You having dinner with Scott?
No. Scott and Dawn are going to Zach's parents.
Cheryl's doing that, too, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I guess you'll be doing something with Diane.
No. She flew back east to be with her parents.
Huh.
So, who are you going to have dinner with?
The Coreys. Ada invited me. What?
She did the same thing to me. What was that I was saying about fate?
Well, do you think it is for us or against us?
Ask me tonight.
You know how I feel. This thing can't go wrong.
so proud to say I love you. Your love's got me high, I long to get by. This time is forever, love is the answer. I hear your voice now, you are my choice now. The love you bring, heaven's in my heart. At your call I hear the harps and angels sing. You know how I feel, this thing can't go wrong. I can't live my life without you. I just can't hold.
Okay, I know that I've done a lot of things wrong in my life and that I'm hard-headed, but this is a little different.
It's my decision.
How long before you start to show?
Probably a couple more months.
Well, that's not much time. Why don't you go ahead and tell him now?
Because I am hoping he will realize that he can still love me.
Have you two talked at all?
Oh, yes, I've tried. It didn't work out too well.
Well, this is the perfect opportunity to try again.
No, I am not going to tell him, and John, neither are you.
Lies and secrets have torn this family apart, and they've got to stop.
Donna, how are you doing?
I'm doing better.
You really feeling okay?
Yes, I'm just a little tired, that's all.
None of that morning sickness?
No, no, not this time. I've been very lucky.
Lucky? Yeah. Well, listen, if you need anything, call me.
John, I mean it.
Are you really feeling better?
Yes, it's like nothing even happened.
Donna, what was Father doing here?
I don't know, but I'm just glad John got rid of him. Listen, I want to hear about these feelings that Cass has for you.
Oh, I'm not certain how deep they are.
Do you really think he's falling in love with you?
You do, don't you?
Well,
he kissed me. And it wasn't in front of other people this time.
Well, there it is. Perfectly chilled champagne. Now, all we need is Mac.
We've got him. He's on his way in. I just saw him coming.
Oh, that took a little bit longer than I thought it would.
What did?
I think this is going to be a marvelous Thanksgiving.
Mac, what is going on?
Pop the champagne, Adam, and pour an extra glass.
Why?
And put it right there in the center of the room. I have a surprise.
A ghost is coming to dinner.
No, this person is very, very much alive.
Who?
Well, it's someone we have missed enormously, not only here, but at the complex. Someone who keeps us on our toes, keeps us laughing.
Max.
Somebody that we would never want to leave again.
No, come on, tell us.
Ta-da! Boo! Oh! Liz!
Liz Matthews, is that you? Are you here to stay?
Darling, someone has to help you boss the Corys around.
Liz, welcome.
I've missed you all so much. Matthew, you've grown so. Aida.
Oh, how great to see you. Welcome. Oh,
James. Hello.
I have to go.
Oh, it's too soon.
My parents are going to be worried about
me. So when am I going to meet your parents?
Not tonight. Oh, I mean, we don't even live around here. This is a very rich area.
Yeah, so you said.
so I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
What, not tonight?
No, I think tomorrow. What are you looking at?
That's the Corey house.
It's huge.
Can you imagine all those servants scurrying around? Kind of like upstairs, downstairs.
Yeah, I guess it's pretty tiresome having that many people underfoot all the time.
Yeah, I couldn't stand it. I mean, ordering those people around. All those servants underfoot.
Yeah, well, I guess I'd hate it too.
You know, that's another thing I like about you.
What?
Well, you're not the type to go in for that kind of stuff.
We have to talk soon, Sam.
About what?
Oh, a lot of things.
Okay, fine. Hey, I want to know everything about you, okay?
Bye, Sam. Mm-hmm.
Dandelion wine, how hip can you get, Grandma?
That's right. Make fun of your poor ancient grandmother.
Hey, now, this is a family tradition for as long back as I can remember. We've had it every year.
It is a tradition. Why, I even remember making it when Michael and John were over in that terrible war.
Got a glass for me, Mom?
John, you made it. Oh, oh. Now my Thanksgiving is really complete.
Hi, Vicky.
Hello, Uncle John.
Mike.
Happy Thanksgiving, John.
Smells good in here, just like I remembered.
Well, good, then stay and eat with us.
No, I can't.
You are staying, and there's an end of it. Now, here. Have a glass of dandelion wine. There you are.
Thank you.
Now, let's drink a toast. Let's drink to us all being here together.
Hmm? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now, do you know, I've always dreamed of having a granddaughter who's helping me in the kitchen. Vicky, you're it. Bring your wine.
Just saw Donna. She's lonely.
Well, you were there.
She wants you.
Yeah, well, my marriage is over.
You can't even see her.
I'm going to Europe.
Europe? How long are you going to be gone?
I'm going to be gone a long time. I don't know. I got a lot of business to do there.
What about Vicky?
Well, she's going to go with me for part of the time, even though she doesn't know it yet.
Look, Mike, consider the stakes. Send someone else to Europe.
Do me a favor, would you? Just stay out of my business.
The best favor I can do you is to make this my business.
You know, 20 years ago, I was pregnant with Michael's children. And I didn't know where he was. I didn't know if I was ever going to see him again.
This isn't a case of history repeating itself, Donna.
Well, it might just happen again.
No, it won't. As soon as John tells Michael that you're pregnant...
No, he won't, and he can't. What do they say about silence being deafening? This house is really empty now. But I deserve it.
Oh, Donna, you stop this right now. Everything's going to change. There'll be years of happy times ahead. A lifetime.
I hope you're right.
I am. And it's all going to begin this Friday afternoon when I marry Cass.
Nicole, I hope you know what you're doing.
And I hope you'll be there right beside me. Will you?
You know I will be.
I'll need someone to hold my hand.
Got it.
Okay.
It's a tad early to be playing Cupid, don't you think? This is Thanksgiving, not Valentine's Day.
I haven't got a clue what you're talking about.
Good.
It's as if I'd never been away.
Are you really back?
San Diego is beautiful, but Bay City is my home.
Well, now that you're used to a life of leisure, I don't suppose you'd take on a job or anything.
Actually, I wanted to talk to you about that.
The executive assistant for the owner and publisher is open.
Wide open? Not that you'd be interested.
I think I'll have to get back to you on that, Mac.
Get back to me?
Darlings, you're forgetting. I've been in California. I don't do anything now without first checking with my agent.
Amanda, where have you been?
Walking. Aunt Liz?
Hi! Amanda! You've blossomed.
Well, now that everybody's here, time for the toast of Thanksgiving.
Oh, yes, good.
Can I have some champagne?
That'll have to be your decision, won't it?
Go.
Dear friends, dear family, well, how fortunate we are just to be able to say those words. How fortunate we are that the past year has brought us the most precious gift of all, the gift of life itself, and that we could live it as we choose in this land that is our land. And how fortunate we are that the coming year will give to each of us innumerable choices. May we all choose wisely. May we choose the right. And may we live our choices joyfully. To the future.
To the future.